Good morning and welcome to worship here at Maple Avenue United Methodist Church on this, the first Sunday of 2021, which is also Epiphany Sunday. I'm so glad that you've joined us, and I hope that you'll take a moment to fill out a Connect card to let us know you stopped by. As you know, today we are only offering online worship. Know that our leadership meets this coming week to discuss future plans for worship. So I hope that you'll pay close attention to church emails and phone messages so that we can share those plans with you. Also, friends, if you feel led to give to the ministries here at Maple Avenue today, know that you can do so by going to our website, mapleavenuechurch.org, or you can give by text messaging any dollar amount to 833-315-0263. I want to stop and quickly thank everyone in the Maple Avenue family for your generosity in 2020. In the midst of a difficult year, our congregation was able to continue to do mission and ministry while also adding new offerings for our congregation and our community. Friends, I'm truly looking forward to what new opportunities 2021 has for us to grow in our ability to love God and love our neighbor. Friends, I also want to encourage you to take a moment to check out the announcements. You can find them on our website or in the church email. And if you have any questions or concerns, please do not hesitate to call the church office or to reach out to me directly. We'd love to hear from you, and we would love to help. Again, I want to thank you for joining us for worship today. And now, would you pray with me as we begin our time of worship? Oh God, we thank you for this new day and for the opportunity we have to worship, even when conditions require us to be apart. We ask that by your Spirit you draw us together, and we ask that you find our offering this day pleasing to you, and that it might truly show our gratitude and our love. For it's in Christ's name we pray. Amen. Friends, would you join me now as we read from Isaiah chapter 60, verses 1 through 3. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the people. But the Lord will arise upon you, and His glory will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Friends, the grass withers and the flowers fall, but the Word of God stands forever. Amen. So friends, have you ever had a bad day? Sure you have. Everyone has had a bad day. There are days where things just don't seem to go quite like we planned. And I'm guessing that for some of you, 2020 was filled with bad days. You know, I think about the University of Florida and their bowl game this past week. Talk about a bad day. But then again, on a more serious note, 2020 was filled with some difficult moments. And for some, 2020 was filled with devastating moments. Still, I'm mindful that as we read the story of Israel, we realize that they too had their bad days. They had their devastating moments. At one point in their story, they were defeated by Babylon. Their city was destroyed and the people were exiled. You know, being in exile was this constant reminder that they were defeated, that another nation had come in and had beaten them and had forcibly removed them from their homeland. I can remember a former church where we had a family that was divided. The mom was a graduate from Georgia Tech and the dad was a graduate from the University of Georgia. And they had this ongoing wager around the game in November each year. Whichever team won, that team's flag would fly in that family's front yard for an entire year. It was a daily reminder that one team had won and the other team had lost. Friends, in some ways, exile worked like that. It was a daily reminder that Israel had lost. It was a dark moment in their history, this time of defeat. Still, it would not be their final moment. God was with them, and in the right moment, God would rescue them and restore them. And friends, it's in the midst of this restoration period that we hear the words of God spoken through the prophet Isaiah, "Arise, shine, for your light has come." God has come in a big way to help restore the people. He has brought them to this new period in their life and in their history. And now the question was, how will Israel respond to God's love and care? God now has made them a strong people, a people that others will take note of, a people that others will want to know more about. Will their lives reflect God's love and care into the world? Will their lives show the world that they are God's people and that they will be, and will they be bold and faithful in how they live moving forward? That is the question that's left to Israel. You know, friends, in some ways, the same question can be asked of all of us. Will we live as bold and faithful followers of God? Just as God came to aid Israel in their moment of need, God has come to our aid in Jesus Christ. That's the truth that we celebrate each Christmas, is it not? Jesus, Emmanuel, God with us. He comes to us when we need Him. Friends, we didn't deserve it. We can never earn it. But still, God comes to help and to save us. And friends, we go on to celebrate the good news that God didn't just come for Israel, but God came for the world, which is part of what we celebrate each Epiphany. God comes to the Magi, And when he comes to them, he is sharing the news that he has come to the world, even the Gentiles. It's good news. It's awesome news that demands more celebration than we truly give it. But still, the question remains, what do we do with this good news? How do we live in light of God coming to the world? You see, just like Israel hears the words to rise and shine and to let their, because their light has come, today we hear these words in the dawn of a new year for ourselves. I'm mindful that so many people have been praying for a new year since last April, and now here we are in 2021. Will this new year have some of the same struggles as last year? Sure. Will 2021 have new issues that we have to navigate? You bet. But still we have this great hope in this new year. We have new opportunities for life and faith, for mission and ministry as a church and as individuals. Each new day gives us new opportunities. And so friends, today as we kickstart this new year, we hear the words of God speaking to the prophet once again, "Rise, shine, for your light has come." Friends, our light has come in Christ. Our hope and our life are in the manger that the Magi would go and visit. Our hope and life is in the empty tomb that Jesus would one day leave. Friends, how are we going to live in light of this truth? Friends, my hope is that we can all use this new year to boldly live out our faith. That we can use this year to improve ourselves and how we love God and how we love other people. That this new year can be a set of new opportunities for mission and ministry for us as the congregation. Friends, I'm mindful that each year or each new year, people make resolutions. Perhaps you've already made a few. Hopefully you're still keeping to them as it's only day 3. Still, I want to give all of us as Maple Avenue a set of goals. I'd like to see all of us take time this year to increase the time that we spend in study of the Bible and in prayer. I'd like to encourage all of us to commit to being in worship each week. And I understand that everybody can't be in the building each week, but now that we have online offerings, I hope that you will commit to being in worship each week, even if it's online. I hope that you'll all commit to sacrificially giving, both your time and your money. Mission and ministry opportunities, friends, will only grow in the new year. And my hope and prayer is that Maple Avenue will be ready to do all that they can to share the good news of Christ with everyone around us, people here in our community and throughout the world. Friends, again, the call to arise and to shine is a call to step up and to live out our faith, to be strong witnesses to God's care and His goodness in the world. Again, our light has come. And as Jesus reminds us later in His life, we never take our light and hide it in a basket. Rather, we put it in a place where it offers us light to help us see and to help us live our lives. And it's also a light where other people can see and to be drawn to it. We're called to shine. So friends, how are we going to shine for Christ in this new year that is upon us? Again, will you commit to study and prayer and worship? Will you carve out more time for mission and ministry, both to your family, to your friends, to people in your workplace, to your neighbors, and to others throughout the world? Friends, how are you going to shine for Christ this year? Again, 2021 is going to send to all of us plenty of opportunities to share Christ. But friends, we have to be working now, preparing ourselves so that we are ready when those opportunities come. And the goals that I've laid out for us just a moment ago will certainly help us to be ready whenever opportunities arise. Friends, I want to close today by bragging on the Maple Avenue family. You all did an awesome job as the church in 2020. In a difficult year, you were faithful to step up time and time again to support our projects and our missions. And because of the faithfulness of this church family, we have taken new steps to shine the light of Christ long into the future of this congregation and this community. You did a great job, and I can never say thank you enough. But now, as we enter this new year, I'm mindful that ministry never stops, and that this new year, 2021, will have even more opportunities to bear Christ's light to the world. So friends, in light of all we've been able to do in 2020, and in light of the new opportunities that are coming in this new year, I dare you all to do it again. Friends, be faithful. Rise, shine, and let the love of God and the love for people shine through all of us in 2021. Amen. Now, friends, would you pray with me? O God of us all, we thank you for the new year you have given us, a year filled with opportunities for mission and ministry, a year filled with opportunities to bear your light to the world. God, we ask that you would forgive us for the times when we have not been ready or eager to share the good news of Jesus with the world. Rather, we pray that you would help us to grow in our passion for you and our passion for ministry. As we enter this new year, we ask for your blessing on your church, the church here at Maple Avenue and throughout the world. Give us a vision for the future. Help us to see the opportunities you are placing before us to be a true witness for Christ. Help us to be faithful in our goals to grow closer to you, to know you better, and to better see your will for our life. God, as we pause and pray, we lift up those who are sick, injured, and hurting. We pray for the many who are battling cancer, those struggling with COVID. We lift up others who are sick and injured. We lift up those who have lost loved ones. We ask for your blessing for those who are struggling financially in this difficult time. God, we thank you that you never leave us. Regardless of how bad the situation may look, we know that you are always with us. And we thank you for giving us the blessing and the opportunity as a church to bear your light to the world, to remind others that you are always with us, to help where we can, to share the good news of your love and mercy. We thank you for the opportunities to go into the world and to offer help when others are in need. God, as we pray, we also pray for our leaders, for church leaders, school leaders, community leaders, leaders in the state government and in our country, leaders throughout the world as we strive to have a wonderful 2021. God, as we pray for our leaders, we ask that you help them to be humble and wise. God, we can never thank you enough for all that you do for us, your people. We are truly thankful for this day, for your presence in our life, and for your constant love and care for us. We especially thank you for Christ, in whose name we pray. And now we pray the prayer which Christ taught to his friends long ago, as we join in praying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning. Praise for them springing fresh from the word.
Friends, again, I want to thank you for joining us for worship in this new year of 2021. Now, as you go out into this new day and into this new year, may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift His countenance upon you and give you peace. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, go now in peace. Amen.